There are different ways to approach keeping your New Year's resolutions, and this one breaks it down to build you up. Welcome former Marine and mental toughness expert Eric Rittmeyer, who's going to share his goal crusher formula. Okay, I love this. We love formulas. No math involved for this one, right?
I'm a former Marine, Megan. I'm not good with the whole reading and writing and counting stuff, so I got to keep it simple.
Okay, we like that. Well, tell us your formula, because we all have goals and we want to crush them.
Yeah, we sure do. You know what's so crazy about New Year's resolutions? You know, like 90% of New Year's resolutions fail before the end of the first month of the year. It's a crazy number. And I think what it boils down to and where this whole formula came from, there's just a few components that you have to have. Number one is the dissatisfaction. It's just something you're unhappy with physically, mentally, emotionally. That's the dissatisfaction, something you're unhappy with. The V is the vision. And this is where I feel like it's most missing with our goals. We have to have a why, an emotionally charged why we're doing what we're doing. The P is the easy part. It's the ABCs and the 1-2-3s. It's the processes. It's how we do what we do. All three of those things together must be greater than the C, which is the cost. That's the price we have to pay. So if we're unhappy, if we have an emotionally charged vision, if we know how to do it, the cost at that point becomes irrelevant.
Oh, okay. And cost doesn't necessarily even mean like money.
Not at all. It's just the price you have to pay, right? So everything this time of year normally revolves around dieting and exercise and losing weight. So a prime example of this would be if the price you have to pay is getting out of bed early in the morning or not eating every time you're hungry or dieting, if that's the price you have to pay, if you're unhappy, if you have the vision, the emotionally charged vision, if you know how to do it, those things together, the getting out of bed in the morning becomes a lot easier when you have all those things in place.
Okay, so let's go back to the D, because you mentioned dissatisfaction. I would think that is a big reason why people do sort of fall off the wagon, because maybe we're, you know, we just had, I think, someone in telling us they wanted to read more books, but if you don't really have a reason for doing that, maybe you'll fall off.
You know, that, it's funny you say that, Megan, because that's really what it boils down to. Even with weight, let's say, you know, if you have someone who is overweight, if they're not unhappy with the fact they're overweight, that's going to be a bit of an issue. You have to get to that point where you really thoroughly are just like, hey, I'm done with this. Every individual person has their time when they get there, but you have to find something that really just gets to the gut of what's upsetting you. Again, not just physically, could be mentally, could be emotionally as well.
And the vision is the why part of the equation, you said. So that's kind of similar as far as you need to, if your goal's too vague, maybe that's going to set you up for failure.
Yeah, the why is such a critical component here. In the world of mental toughness, we say you use the logic for the how and the emotion for the why, meaning that logic serves its purpose, but logic's good for ABCs and 1-2-3s. Emotion is very good for getting you off the couch when it's time to go. If you don't have that strong emotionally charged why you do what you do, what you're willing to jump in front of a bus for, if that why is not very clearly defined, when the going gets tough, you're just going to quit.
Okay, so D plus V plus P has to be greater than C. Is that right? Did I kind of sum that up?
Just think about it. The pain plus the why plus the how must be greater than the price you have to pay. That's the easiest way to remember it.
And can this go for any sort of goal we want to do this year?
It goes for every piece of life, Megan. That's what I love about this. It's not just goals. It's with relationships. It's stuff at work. It's stuff at home. If you have all those components together, these issues that we think are so difficult, the pain that we think we have to go through to get whatever the goal is that we're looking for, the pain becomes less relevant because we're doing something that drives us, that truly means something at the core of who we are.
And you have a book that can help us with our mental toughness, right?
I do. It's the Emotional Marine. Thank you for that. It's a camouflage cover, so be careful if you buy it. Be careful where you leave it. You might lose it. You get it? It's camouflage. Be careful. They get worse. Don't worry. It's just all about connecting with people and just how to be kind to others, how to have emotional connections, especially with this year we got coming up. It's getting ready to turn, unfortunately, pretty hostile, I think. We're just in this environment right now where people are going to start getting a little stirred up with the election process. Just remember, we're all humans. We're all hardwired to feel first and think later. Kuna Matata, be kind to each other.
Well, Eric, thanks so much for being here. We are ready to crush it in 24.
Awesome seeing you, Megan. Thanks for having me.
Loss of hearing can be affected by many different things that you may not realize.